can see that there's just a couple of little screws right here that are holding everything together. So that's how I'm going to make sure parts that are secure around it. And then I'm going to check the condition and all seems to be cracked or broken. I'm also going to look inside the hole to make sure that it's clean of debris or rust or corrosion there. And then on the trailer electric connector, same thing, you know, make sure that it's secured and onto with all the nuts and the bolts. And then nothing that's cracked or broken there. Trailer slide onto the truck, because if you didn't have that metal plate, you would have all those holes in it that just get stuck, right? It would never be able to slide on. So this is the apron. It is being welded to the bottom of the trailer. There's no nuts and bolts on it, it's the welds. So instead of talking about nuts and bolts down, I have to make sure that it's nice and flat, because I want it to be able to slide on and off of the truck easily, and also make sure that it can turn easily.
The apron is the part that's on the truck, on the tractor or the trailer?
It's metal right here. What I'm hitting right there, part of the trailer. Yes. You can also see that it's full of grease. Tell them, I will make sure that it's full of grease, because that grease also helps it slip and slide on there easily, right? Twist and turn with no friction between the truck and the trailer. Air metal, cause friction wise. And grease helps there not be any friction. Right below it, this one right here on the bottom, this is what you see all right here. And that is the fifth wheel skid plate. If you look on the sides, you can see that there's pins and nuts and bolts, and y'all can see them over there too.